Hi, welcome to Uber Micro Repairs, and on the Healy Bench today we have a piece of software. A piece of software that maybe several years ago would have been absolutely fantastic to have. However, now the PS4 has been announced as end of life, or soon to be, it's a little bit bittersweet. Maybe too little, too late. Anyway, let's get on with it. So on the bench here we have a PS4 controller main board, and this board is a JDM40. As you can see here, it's got standard analogs. The rotors have been changed just for this test because they weren't all that great, and I've had to run a bodge wire on this right stick to make it work. But there is just factory soldering. These sticks are worn out, completely worn out, as you can see right here. So we have quite a nice drift there on the right stick in the upper left, and we have another drift on the left stick there, and there we go, it's sort of lower left quadrant. So these sticks, no matter what you do with them, will drift permanently. So this is screwed. If I was to replace these analog sticks again, there would probably be a slight drift on them, because each analog is calibrated at factory to the firmware in the controller. So this is where people have come up with various methods. Some of them are little mod boards which go on the back with potentiometers to zero in the center point. However, that robs from full travel, so when you go full extreme, left, right, up or down, it might only go to 85, 95, 98%, which will translate in game to the character going one way 100%, nice and quick, and then you go the other direction and it'll go slower, and that can be frustrating, and that's not how these controllers should be repaired. The other way of doing things is to put small resistors between the pins of the potentiometers. Again, in my opinion, that's another rinky-dink solution, which again will rob from full travel. As I've always said, getting these sticks centered has always been the easy part. It's getting 100% travel all around the clock which has been the difficult part. However, it can be done. There are other ways to manipulate the pots to get these centered and get 100% travel, with removing the nubs and physically moving them, or moving the axis nub and twisting it, as you see in my videos. What I've got is a piece of software that will actually write back the resistance readings of the pots to firmware, just like you would calibrate a stick in Windows. Not only does it do the center, it also does the extreme 100% all around the clock, and it also, believe it or not, calibrates the triggers. So it's a very nice piece of software, but as I said earlier, too little too late, because, well, we're not going to see too many of these for repair soon. On top of that, the software isn't user friendly at all. It's a Python script. You do have to do some hocus pocus with drivers. It's not for the faint-hearted. And last but not least, you can brick your controller. So if you're doing this to an expensive SCUF controller, AIM, Battle Beaver, anything like that, there is potential to turn it into a brick and you'd have to replace the board. So a word of caution, what I'm about to show you isn't a tutorial. This is just to show you that this software does exist, and just a basic grasp on how to use it. Again, this is not a tutorial. I will show enough in here so you can go off, explore it by yourself. I will not really be answering any questions on how to install it, how to mess about with the USB drivers, commands, and I certainly 110% will not be responsible if you screw up a controller. But with that said, let's get on with it. Here we have the controller lit up and it's on. We have DS for Windows here, and the controller is being picked up. So what we need to do, we need to change the Windows driver, which is a HID USB driver, which it's currently using, to a libusb-win32 driver, so the calibration software can read the controller. So in order to do that, there are two interfaces on this controller. One is the main human part of it for pressing the buttons and the analogs, and the other side is for the audio out. So we need to change the driver for both. So first of all, we'll go wireless controller interface 3, and as you can see there, HID human interface device USB, and we need to change it to the libusb. Let's hit replace driver and wait a few seconds. What this will do, it'll install the driver, and what I'm going to do, I'll end up ending this in order to speed things up a little bit. So we'll wait for it to appear in device manager here, and there it is. I'm wondering whether to just leave this running for a second longer, because I don't want to have to remove it nastily if I don't have to. Just give it a few seconds longer. Okay, I'm getting bored now, so yep, we'll just end that task and then we'll rerun ZA Diag again. Options, list all devices. So we've done that on interface 3, and we can see interface 3 here in device manager. And then if we go to interface 0, you can see USB audio. This is the other part of the controller, and again, select libusb and replace driver. And again, after a few seconds, we should see interface 0 appear in device manager. And there he is. So we've got both of them there. Again, we don't have to wait for ZA Diag to complete. We can just end task and be nasty to it. There we go. Okay, at this point, if we power cycle the controller, DS4 Windows is gone. Okay, and it doesn't come back, which is good. So the controller is on, but we've got a flashing light. Not sure if you can see that. There we go. And DS4 Windows here is completely out. So let's open up the script. Now we want a command window with admin rights. Okay, DIR, and two tools that we're after is the tool and the calibration. The calibration is the meat and potatoes of this, but just to make sure that this is actually talking to the software, let's just run DS4 tool and ask it for some info. So DS tool info, hit return, and there we go. Found DualShock 4 and compiled, time and date, we've got hardware version, and we've got some software there. So let's move straight over to the calibration tool, hit enter, and we want option 1, so that will center the sticks. Hit enter, and we just want to go W to store the calibration straight away. Done. So that was the sample data to begin with, which basically means the sticks were off center, and now it's put them to 0, 0, which is good. And if you want to do the range, we want to run the tool again and select option 2, hit enter, and now it's asking to move the sticks to the extremes. It is a bit funny when the board is out of the controller, because you can move the sticks further than they're supposed to go, and it doesn't like that. So I'll just do the best effort, so we'll just go round in a circle without going all the way to the edge, because again it's not in the shell, so we'll just go around like that. And then the same for this stick, just do it a few times. Okay, done. Press any key. Okay, so it's found some data, sample 1 and 2, so I'll probably assume that's left stick. Top one is left stick, bottom one is right stick, and we're done. We can exit out of that. Now we need to get the HID driver back installed so Windows can now see the controller. So again, we're still flashing. DS4 Windows can't see it. And we've still got these here, so what we want to do is right click on each one, uninstall, delete driver, uninstall, and then same for the other one, uninstall, delete. Okay, and before we power cycle the controller, we need to get rid of that driver, and it's in Windows System 32 drivers, and we're looking for libusb0.sys. So we will just rename that .old. As you can see, I've done this several times from all the .olds there. So continue, yes, yes. Okay, now the controller is off, completely off. Power cycle it. Device manager refreshing there and plug him in. Okay. And as you can see there, DS4 Windows has found the controller. Okay, and we don't get any lib devices in Device Manager, so that's good. So now we go to DS4 Windows, click on that, and as we can see, we have actually calibrated the right stick and it's perfect. Let's just go into raw read mode. As we can see, the right stick is perfectly calibrated. The left one is off. It's a hell of a lot better than it was. I will put a picture in picture of how it was before compared to now, and you will definitely notice a big improvement there. Like I say, these sticks are completely worn out, so I wouldn't expect it to do miracles. But yeah, there we go. And we can power cycle the controller again. Plug him in. Let's go back, and as you can see, the calibration has stuck. And if we actually press the reset on the back, and there we go, it's still there. So I wouldn't expect this tool to work miracles, because as I say, if the carbon track is worn out in your potentiometer, it needs to be replaced. It won't fix that. And also, if the spring tension inside the module, the snapback, if that's all worn out, again, it won't help you with that. You'll need to replace the modules. This isn't a magic wand fix. But as I said before, this is a little bit bittersweet, because this tool would have been very welcomed several years ago. However, too little too late. There we go. We can now calibrate DS4 controllers. Anyway, I hope you found this interesting. I found this tool very interesting, and appreciate you watching, and take care.